Hi everyone, I'm Mary with Mary Greeley News. Thank you for joining me. Yesterday there in Oklahoma at 11:48 a.m. there was a magnitude 4.2 earthquake. Did you feel it? So far, 314 people did report feeling this earthquake on USGS. In the last week, there's been 28 earthquakes in this area, and more likely is caused by an unknown fault zone from the Humboldt Fracture Zone. The Humboldt Fracture Zone extends all the way from Ohio down to Texas. Not much research has been done on the location and the adjoining faults. They do know that fracking, the injection of wastewater wells, can cause a major, and I mean a major, earthquake there in Oklahoma, Texas, etc. The Humboldt Fracture Zone is a cause of tectonic forces, pressure, mountain building from the Mid-Continent Zone, Mid-Continent Rift Zone. Here on ResearchGate, it says the Humboldt Fault Zone is a complex series of basement faults that extends southwestward from Nebraska through eastern Kansas into Oklahoma. This basement fault is made up of rhyolite, yep, the most volcanic explosive type magma. It's all hardened now, but also granite, and it's buried beneath sediment, a little more than a half a mile to almost 2 miles deep. Yeah, a lot of sediment above where that fault zone extends. You notice the line here. More likely, it is an extension of the Humboldt Fault from that earthquake. Let me zoom in. There's the magnitude 4.2 and the subsequent earthquakes afterwards. And there was 5 earthquakes prior to this 4.2, a 2.6, 5 kilometers in depth, a 2.3, 7.4 kilometers in depth, a 3.7, a 3.5, and a 2.8, and there's the location of that 4.2. Here on this paper by USGS, it says that, as noted, fluid injection can induce fault slip. But this slip may be manifested by either a stable creep or seismic event. Depending on the fault seismic, that is frictional stability, at the given temperature pressure conditions. Here is an image also on this page by USGS showing all the fracture zones going along with the Humboldt Fracture Zone side by side. This paper also says our analysis explains why Oklahoma basement faults are susceptible to reactivation by wastewater injection in such a way that has led to the widespread intense seismicity within the current stress field. These pre-existing faults are weak zones waiting to be reactivated, similar to previously documented reactivation of basement faults in the New Madrid area of the central United States. The Oklahoma basement is in the southern part of the rhyolite granite provinces of the U.S. mid-continent, which extends from West Texas to Western Ohio. The Southern Rhyolite Granite Province has undergone multiple phases of tectonic deformation that included Precambrian north-north-south, south-southwest rifting, followed by reverse faulting. Most of the recent earthquake activity in Oklahoma has occurred in the north-central region of the state, where the crystalline Precambrian basement is covered by a 1 to 3 kilometer thick veneer of sedimentary strain. That's about a half a mile to almost 2 mile thick of sediment above this fault zone. They also know that injecting of wastewater can induce earthquakes about 25 miles away from that location. The largest earthquake recorded so far in Oklahoma was in 2016, a magnitude 5.8. 61,967 people reported feeling that earthquake on USGS. It was felt over a very large area, and that's because it's filled with sediment. Look at that. We got all the way up here in Minnesota, North Dakota, South Dakota. Reports from Texas, New Mexico, Colorado, Ohio, Pittsburgh, etc. USGS did downgrade that earthquake to a magnitude 5.6. It says, without studying the specifics of the wastewater injection and oil and gas production in this area, the USGS cannot currently conclude whether or not this particular earthquake was caused by industrial-related human activity. However, we do know that many earthquakes in Oklahoma have been triggered by wastewater fluid injection. USGS was originally funded by the oil and gas industry using American tax dollars to do their research for them to find new fields for their industry. Now, there is an updated paper. You gotta search for it on USGS. I'll give you a link to it. It does say that the largest earthquake induced by fluid injection has been documented in scientific literature was a magnitude 5.8. They downgraded that to a 5.6 on September 23rd, 2016 in central Oklahoma. Four magnitude 5 or greater earthquakes have occurred in Oklahoma, three of which occurred in 2016. In 2011, a magnitude 5.3 earthquake was induced by fluid injection in the Raton Basin, Colorado. I've been trying to find the cost of the damage from these earthquakes, and I did find this paper here. It says, as for Oklahoma, the situation is becoming critical as the seismic activity shows no sign of stopping. A swarm of induced earthquakes has erupted beneath the largest U.S. inland oil storage depot at Cushing, and in September 2016, there was a moment magnitude of a 5.8 earthquake located 8 miles from the town of Pawnee, which caused serious damage to buildings. A lot of people were injured. Were a magnitude 6 point or greater earthquake to hit near Edmond, outside of Oklahoma City, our model shows it could cause billions of dollars of damage. I have not heard of any reports where anyone won a lawsuit against the oil and gas industry. They're claiming that because these earthquakes are down there in the basement of the fault zone, well below where they inject the fluids, that it is not caused by them. But in my opinion, we all know that is not true. So more than likely, you did have some light damage from this recent earthquake, the magnitude 4.2. If so, please put your comments down below. Are you taking precautions to get ready for a major earthquake? Well, they evidently know that you could have a magnitude 6 or greater, and that would definitely be felt, and injuries and damage would be over a very large area. Are you prepared? So what are your thoughts? Please put your comments down below. Please stay safe, and I'll talk to you later. God bless y'all. Bye.